overviewing the antennas on my Mooney M-20F. First of all, underneath the right fuselage is the marker beacon antenna. Here's my hand for scale.
Modern marker beacon antennas, like on my airplane, are about 8 inches long. They receive on a single frequency about 75 megahertz. The signal is highly directional and so only covers a small area. Older marker beacon antennas looked like this and were about 3 feet long.
This receives signals in the headset for outer marker, middle marker, inner marker for instrument approaches.
In this localizer approach at Knoxville Downtown Island Airport, the outer marker indicates rise and waypoint where the pilot can descend from 2500 to 1820. Only having one frequency is a limitation, though. Marker beacons don't differentiate themselves, so you need to know you're in the right place. This approach into Knoxville McGee Tyson has typical outer and middle markers. But the early part of the approach overflies the outer marker from the Downtown Island approach.
Here is the transponder antenna. This is
about 1 gigahertz
band antenna. So this receives signals from air traffic control, secondary radar, and sends back a signal which includes our altitude. This would also be the size for a DMA antenna, but I don't have an explicit DMA in this airplane. This looks vaguely like an antenna, but this is the pitot tube for the airspeed indicator. That's a mechanical device. Now more antennas. This is a COM antenna. This is one of the radios. I presume this is COM 1.
COM antennas are vertically polarized. They receive and transmit from 118 to 137 megahertz to talk to air traffic control and other airplanes.
Under here, this antenna right here, this one, is, I presume, it's another COM antenna, I presume COM 2.
This antenna is on the belly, so it's a different shape.
These are battery vents, they're not antennas. On the tail, these antennas, this is sort of a two-part antenna. It's horizontal. This is the VOR navigation antenna. It also receives glide slope signals from ILS.
This antenna is horizontally polarized. It receives in two bands, 108 to 118 megahertz for VOR navigation and localizer signals, and 328 to 336 megahertz for glide slope signals. The two different signal bands are separated for the radio by a signal splitter like this.
And then lastly, the two GPS antennas. So on the top rear, this is the GPS antenna for the Garmin 430W.
W is for WAS, which means it can do more precise GPS approaches.
And this is the antenna for the Apollo GX60.
I'll be doing a video on the GX60, which Garmin is sunsetting support for, which makes me very sad. That's it. Please click like and subscribe and never stop figuring stuff out.